What's up, everybody? This is Donnie Klang from MTV's Making the Band. Give a big shout out to Celeb Seekers for you.
How has your life changed from Making the Band
to
now?
It's like since we filmed till now. I mean, it's been crazy. I was able to finally get a house. I used to just live in like apartments with my mom. So that was a big difference, finally getting to like live in a house with a backyard, and driveway and all that good stuff. Get to have people over, have parties, get a little crazy. Besides that, just like the traveling and everything, it's almost like a catch-22 because, I mean, like, it's great and I love it, but I miss like my best friend's wedding, my cousin's wedding, like baby showers and stuff. So you like miss some like the important family stuff, and I'm like family oriented, so like I'm into that stuff. But then it's great. I wouldn't trade it for anything because it's awesome. All the traveling.
How did you get involved with this foundation?
Actually, just through Facebook. My dad. He has the same name as me, so his Facebook, you would think maybe it's me. And the family was messaging him, thinking it was me, and he thought it was somebody else named Danny from my town that I did a fundraiser for last year. So he was like, oh yeah, definitely, we'll come back out again. And they were like, again? They're like, this is the first one we're throwing, so it kind of just all fell into place. And then we just fell in love with the family, they fell in love with us, they saw we're good people, they're good people. And the kid is great, so I mean, just whatever we could do. I was open today, I had nothing else to do. So I mean, it was like a no-brainer just to come out here and try to help out and raise money for that.
Okay, if you were to coordinate a charity, what would you do to raise money?
All right, guys. How you doing, man? Not bad.
Hey, how are you?
I would have to say probably like a lupus foundation. My mom has lupus, so it's something that's like right at home for me, and she's doing great with it. But you never know, like at any moment she might be back in the doctors, back in hospitals and stuff. So I mean, that's definitely something that I would, hits home. So that's something I would want to help raise money for. And probably what I'd want to do is like maybe some kind of high school college tour and see if like Justin Bieber will come out. Jay Sean, Jason Derulo. Me and Jason Derulo wrote like a lot of my first albums, so he's a close contact.
Yeah.
I know a lot of people at Def Jam. I know Usher and stuff, so maybe to reach out. Yeah, even me. just try to get a whole bunch of people together and do like a nice big concert to help raise money for the
What do you have in store for your fans next?
Next is, I'm really just taking my time with my next album. I know a lot of people are asking for it. They think maybe I disappeared and stuff. And it's not that. It's just I've been writing a lot for like other artists and everything. And also, I'm trying to like start my own record label up. So to me, I thought it was gonna happen overnight. I'm like a little kid. I think like a little kid. And I thought everything was just gonna be like, all right, this is gonna happen, and then I'll put out music on iTunes overnight. But really, it's like a whole business, and you need paperwork and. I've been going into meetings with like a briefcase and stuff, and being a whole businessman trying to just start my own record label, and maybe even sign other artists to it. I've been writing music for other artists and submitting songs, and I think that's just a good way to really get your name out there, is by writing for other artists. Just like Neo. That's how Neo got me. Okay, thank you, man. So just really right now I'm doing the whole business side of everything, and then I'm gonna come out with my album probably like hopefully by the holidays. That's like
excited. Yeah, definitely excited. What was it like working with Diddy?
Wow, working with Diddy. It's probably what you would think it would be. He's crazy. In a good way though. He's like, he's the type of person that he's never impressed. Even if he is impressed, he's never gonna show like he's impressed. But what that just makes you work harder, because you're like, damn, he's not impressed. This is like the greatest thing I ever did. And then you come out with something even better than that. You're still not impressed, and it makes you work harder and harder and harder. So I mean, it was good. And then especially learning the business side of things from him, it's helping out me now, because I'm opening up my own record label and getting the chance to learn from him. It's like, who else could you learn from? That's like the best person to be able to learn from. So I'm trying to follow in his footsteps.
We're right over here, guys. With Danny, come on. If you could write the lyrics to one song,
and then he's like, oh.
Bye, Donnie.
See you later. If I can write the lyrics?
Yeah, just the one lyric that you saw on top of your head.
Something from the top of my head?
Yes.
I mean, the way I write is like very, like, I use metaphors a lot. I was a nerd in high school, so I try to like use like smart lyrics. Like my song "Blindsided," I wrote like about a car accident that happened, and I related the whole thing to the way I felt when my relationship ended, because it came out of nowhere, blindsided me, and just like everything I put in the song was like metaphors to what happened with the relationship. Like I didn't actually get hurt, but I felt like I was hurt. And I didn't actually like have a broken arm, but I felt like I had a broken heart that I need to get over. I need to wear a cast on it. Like, so that's kind of what I felt like. So that's how I write. And if I could write a line, I mean, I would say maybe something like I met her 4 years ago, and then everything in the song would be a metaphor.
Yeah.
Play on.
Oh, that was good. Okie dokie. If you could tour with five of your favorite artists, who would you choose?
Five of my favorite or your favorite?
Your favorite and my favorite.
I'd have to say Boyz II Men would be one. Like Drew Hill, that would be another one. Just because I was a big fan of like all the early 90s R&B groups. I got to tour with the Backstreet Boys already, so I'm not gonna say them, but I'll say maybe NSYNC, because I was a fan of that whole boy band movement. And then I would have to say like Michael Jackson, maybe even if we got him on screen or something, just to like relive his legacy. And then I would have to just say like maybe somebody like Brandy, just to bring a girl into the mix, and I was a huge fan of her. Her voice is incredible. I know a lot of people like hear her songs and think she's great, but like vocally she's just phenomenal. Like
I'm,
yeah, she's crazy. Especially like I'm a fan of like backgrounds and harmonies and stuff, because I sang in a group and her backgrounds and all her harmonies are just ridiculous.
Okay, do you still keep in contact with any members of Naked Men?
Yeah, I stay in touch with pretty much everybody. I had a falling out with Day 26, but we kind of just got over it. We grew up. I think when everything first happened, we were kind of like not that it changed us, but it had to have some effect on us. Like, we went from just regular people. For me, I was working in a warehouse, working at a gym. Then all of a sudden, I'm getting paid thousands of dollars to go sing one song in a club and get free drinks and just be able to party all the time and stuff. So like it automatically kind of changed us a little bit. And I think that's what really happened between us, was we thought like, oh my God, look at us, we're like the hottest thing. And then now it's like, look at Jersey Shore. They just came in and took our spot on MTV. So it's like, I think we kind of just all realized like it's here one day, but you got to keep working at it to keep it here, because it could just go away. So I'm friends with all of them still. I'm friends with Danny Kane. They're all doing good stuff, working on music. Shannon's married.
Wow.
She's working at a dance studio in her town. She's like family oriented like me, so she's everybody's doing good. Can't really say anything bad.
Since our website's all about secrets, can you tell us a secret about yourself?
I think a lot of people don't know I'm from Brooklyn. I grew up in Canarsie, Brooklyn, lived in Mill Basin for a while, so I think a lot of people don't know that. And all the time I hear like Hot 97 and all these DJs, Power 105, they're shouting out Brooklyn, Brooklyn, and they're like, oh, Long Island too, and I'm like, oh, I live in Long Island, I've lived here for like 10 years, but I still think of Brooklyn as home, because that's where I grew up. And I went to high school out here, so I was like, Long Island, Brooklyn, that's like my two homes, so I think that might be a secret.
Good, sounds good. Okay, we're done.
Cause the first thing you would come up to me say, you never even gave me a chance. Don't you be when you show you, you can feel the better baby like he was supposed to. Forget you was wicked, cause you're coming up with us so much now. I'm here to pick you up, I'm picking up the pieces.
All right, DJ, how much
so funny. You can stop it. Yeah, it's fine. Yeah. Okay, once again, I want to thank everybody for coming out here. Give it up one time for Danny. Give it up one time for Smash. He was smashing the stage up here. And Iron Man. Hold on. Let me show you guys Iron Man. His costume's perfect. He's really incognito. We gotta show everybody how high the Hulk can jump. If you guys see the Hulk jump high, make some noise. I know, Danny, you wanna fly around one more time? Yeah, I mean Batman, I'm sorry. Okay, we're gonna be doing a raffle. I have another song I'm gonna perform in a